ಶಮ್ಮಂಗುಡಿ ಶ್ರೀನಿವಾಸ ಅಯ್ಯರ್. Born on July 25, 1908, Shemmangudi Srinivasa Iyer belongs to the village of Shemmangudi, one of the sleepy hollows nestling among the wide expanse of paddy in the Kaveri Delta. Today, it has become a prominent name on the musical map of India. His father Radhakrishna Iyer was a Mirastar and mother Dharmambal, sister of the legendary violinist Thirukkodi Kaval Krishna Iyer. As Srinivasa Iyer was known at home, was born in the house of his illustrious uncle at Thirukkodi Kaval. But unfortunately, he was hardly 4 or 5 years old when Krishna Iyer died and was not able to benefit from his legacy. But he inherited his musical traits, for he showed signs of being a prodigy. His father used to recite Ashtapadis and participate in the bhajani in the temples. Seeing his son's indifference to academics and his extraordinary talent for music, he decided to let him follow the family tradition. He did not have to go far to seek the guru. Krishna Iyer's nephew and son-in-law, Shemmangudi Narayan Swami Iyer, was a celebrated violinist. Chinu was initiated into music by him in 1917. Sambhona vadidi sadalo shiva bhakti illada narargal varunjayave navasiti sadalo shiva bhakti illada narargal varunjayave yavar bhujiyum tale One of the greatest days in the life was when the celebrated Gotuvadiyam player Sakharama Rao came to his house. son of Gotuvadiyam Srinivasa Rao, the first musician to specialize in this instrument, Sakharama Rao had made an even greater contribution to its development. Chinu was asked to sing before him. "Send him to Thiruvudai Madur," commanded the maestro after hearing him. Thus it was that the young hopeful found himself at Thiruvudai Madur, a town near Kumbakonam. Though a very strict teacher, Rao had a special affection for Chinu and addressed him as Chinnapayale or little fellow. Shamangudi has narrated many anecdotes about this musician. Once, when he showed reluctance to accept an invitation for a concert, the organizers pleaded with him and said they would be happy to have him play at least one song. He agreed, but little did they imagine that he would take them literally. The audience had gathered. Sakharama Rao ascended the dais and played Vatapi Ganapatim. Then, to the utter consternation of the organizers, he picked up his Gotuvadiyam and walked out. Chinu's apprenticeship under Sakharama Rao was twice blessed. Apart from the excellent training imparted by his guru, the ambience of the region, redolent of the music of the Bhagavatas and temple melams, had much to offer to an aspiring musician. Thiruvudai Madur was an important cultural center and attracted several eminent musicians. Chinu got an opportunity to hear all of them. His most evocative description of that period is of the festival of Mahalinga Swami temple, where he heard the great Nagaswaram players. I experience a thrill when I recall those days. The Nagasura Mela Vidwan would offer a picturesque sight indeed, each wearing the dhoti in the Panchakacham style and a silk stole wrapped around the waist, his hair worn in a tuft and his neck adorned with a necklace of Rudrakshara beads. With a towel wrapped around his head against the early morning dew, Chinu would follow the procession swaying in ecstasy to the sound of that divine instrument. When he came home, he would try to repeat the phrases he had heard. The music that seeped into him in his childhood was to reappear at a later stage in his musical career as he modeled his Alapana style on the Nagaswaram pattern.
Da da di di na
the diversity of techniques and styles learned from four distinguished musicians and his own unremitting practice made Shemmangudi a complete musician by the age of 18. In 1926, he had his arangetram at Kumbakonam in the Nageswara Swami temple. Shemmangudi's real break came in 1927 when he participated in the conference organized by the cultural wing of the Indian National Congress, which later became the Madras Music Academy. Making a correct appraisal of his strengths and weaknesses, he decided not to plan his concert program ahead, but to assess the state of the voice at a particular moment. Since pausing for breath or at a note caused his voice to crack, he evolved a technique by which it could be camouflaged. Selecting a narrow range of notes, he would start with simple phrases and build up to an awe-inspiring climax, a maze of complex and interlocking sancharas, all in the same breath. This continuous music, modeled on the Nagaswaram technique, became his bani. The voice that Shemmangudi cultured with determination became the best voice of the generation. Shemmangudi was honored as the Astana Vidwan of the Travancore Darbar in 1939. In 1941, he was invited by the royal family to head the Swati Tirunal Academy of Music after the retirement of its first principal, Harikeshanallur Muthayya Bhagavathar. Among the innumerable disciples of four or five generations trained by the great guru, those who have made it to the top are T.M. Thyagarajan, P.S. Narayan Swami, C.S. Krishna Iyer, and the violinist T.N. Krishnan. Shemmangudi also got the opportunity to train the voice of the century, as M.S. Subbalakshmi was described. He became a lifelong mentor to her and imparted the depth and sophistication which were to become the hallmarks of her style. Shemmangudi was the youngest recipient of the Sangeeta Kalanidhi by the Music Academy in 1947, when he was just about 39 years old. He has received several other coveted awards, including Padma Bhushan and Padma Vibhushan from the Government of India.
Shashanko Karacharanatale.
Shri Shammangudi Srinivasa Iyer passed away on 31st October 2003, but his pure, chaste classical music will ever be embedded in the hearts of all music rasikas.
Mangalam Kosalendraya Mangalam Kosalendraya Magani Magaliyagmatmane Chakravarti 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 Talujaya Sarvabhaumaya Mangalam Mangalam Sokki Prajanya Paripalayantam Nyayena Margena Mahim Mahesha Om Brahmanebhya Shubhamastu Nityam Lokat Samastat Sukhino Bhavam.